भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासां ततो जयमुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अवद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवति उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिके कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। श्रीमद् भागवतम स्कंद तीसरा अध्याय 6 श्लोक संख्या 37 एकांतलाभं वचसो नुपुंसां श्लुक्श्लोकमौलेर्गुणवादमाहु श्रुतेश्च विद्वद्भिरूपकृतायां कथासुधायां उपसंप्रयोगम्। अनुवाद और तात्पर्य कृष्ण कृपा मूर्ति अभय चरणारविंद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद द्वारा। अनुवाद, मानवता का सर्वोच्च सिद्धिप्रद लाभ पवित्र कर्ता के कार्यकलापों तथा महिमा की चर्चा में प्रवृत्त होना है। ऐसे कार्यकलाप महान विद्वान ऋषियों द्वारा इतनी सुंदरता से लिपिबद्ध हुए है कि कान का असली प्रयोजन उनके निकट रहने से ही पूरा हो जाता है। तात्पर्य, निर्विशेषवादी भगवान के कार्यकलापों को सुनने से अतीव भयभीत रहते हैं, क्योंकि वे सोचते हैं कि ब्रह्म के दिव्य पद से प्राप्त सुख ही जीवन का चरम लक्ष्य है। वे सोचते हैं कि हर एक का कार्य, चाहे वह भगवान ही क्यों न हो, लौकिक होता है। किंतु इस श्लोक में सुख का जो भाव व्यक्त है वह भिन्न है, क्योंकि यह परम पुरुष के कार्यों को बतलाता है जिनके गुण दिव्य होते हैं। गुणानुवादम शब्द महत्वपूर्ण है, क्योंकि भगवान के गुण तथा उनके कार्यकलाप एवं उनकी लीलाएं भक्तों की चर्चा के विषय में होते हैं। मैत्रेय जैसा ऋषि निश्चय ही लौकिक गुणों वाली किसी बात की चर्चा करने में रुचि नहीं रखता, फिर भी वे कहते हैं कि दिव्य साक्षात्कार की सर्वोच्च सिद्धिप्रद अवस्था भगवान के कार्यकलापों की चर्चा करना है। इसीलिए श्रील जीव गोस्वामी इस निष्कर्ष पर पहुंचते हैं कि भगवान के दिव्य कार्यकलापों से संबंधित कथाएं कैवल्य सुख की दिव्य अनुभूति से बहुत परे हैं। भगवान के इन दिव्य कार्यकलापों को महर्षियों ने इस प्रकार लिपिबद्ध किया है कि उन कथाओं को सुनने से ही मनुष्य आत्म साक्षात्कार को प्राप्त होता है और कान तथा जीव का भी सदुपयोग हो जाता है। श्रीमद् भागवत ऐसा ही एक महान ग्रंथ है और इसकी विषय वस्तु को सुनने सुनाने मात्र से जीव की सर्वोच्च सिद्धावस्था प्राप्त हो जाती है। ऐसे मोबाइल लेके आएंगे, मोबाइल, मेरा मोबाइल उधर कॉर्नर में। ओम अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवाञ्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सहगणरघुनाथन्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावद्भूतं पर्यनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश। नमा ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिन्यदि नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। एकांतलाभं वचसो नपुंसां सुश्लोकमौलेर्गुणवादमाहु श्रुतेश्च विद्वद्भिररूपाकृतायां कथासुधायां उपसंप्रयोगम्। मानवता का सर्वोच्च सिद्धप्रद लाभ पवित्र कर्ता के कार्यकलापों तथा महिमा की चर्चा में प्रवृत्त होना है। ऐसे कार्यकलाप महीन महान विद्वान ऋषियों द्वारा इतनी सुंदरता से लिपिबद्ध हुए हैं कि कान का असली प्रयोजन उनके निकट रहने से ही पूरा हो जाता है। सुश्लोक, यहाँ पे भगवान को सुश्लोक इस नाम से संबोधित किया गया। भगवान को उत्तम श्लोक भी कहा जाता है और प्रभुपाद अनुवाद में इसका अर्थ बताते हैं कि सुश्लोक यानी पवित्र करता, जो हमें पवित्र करता है। इस अध्याय में और विशेष करके इस श्लोक में मनुष्य समाज के सर्वोच्च सिद्धता के बारे में बताया गया। कई बार हम देखते हैं कि लोग पूछते रहते हैं कि हमारे जीवन का उद्देश्य क्या है, किससे इस जीवन में हम अपने आप को परिपूर्ण बना सकते हैं, अपनी जीवनता के अपने जीवन की जो सिद्धता है उसको कैसे प्राप्त कर सकते हैं, तो उसी की चर्चा इस श्लोक में की गई है। तो यहां पे बताते हैं कि एकांत लाभम वचसोन पुंसा, वचसोन पुंसा यानी बता ही नहीं सकते हम इसके अलावा, किसके अलावा, एकांत लाभ, इस एक लाभ के अलावा, यानी ये एकमात्र ही पद्धति है कि जिसके द्वारा मनुष्य जीवन का उद्देश्य परिपूर्ण हो सकता है, और वो क्या है? सुश्लोकम मौलेर गुणान वादम आहु। ऐसा कहा जाता है कि सुश्लोकम मौले, मौले यानी भगवान के दिव्य कार्यकलाप, भगवान के दिव्य कार्यकलापों की चर्चा, गुणानुवाद, भगवान के दिव्य कार्यकलापों की चर्चा ही एकमात्र उपाय है जो हमें इस भौतिक जगत में हमारे जीवन की समसिद्धि जो है, जीवन का ध्येय जो है, उसे प्राप्त करा के दे सकता है। अन्य ऐसी कोई चीज नहीं है जो हमें इस जीवन के सिद्धता को प्राप्त कर सकता है। यानी मनुष्य जीवन तभी धन्य है जब जीवन में व्यक्ति भगवान के गुणानुवाद, भगवान के दिव्य गुण लीला, इसके श्रवण में अपना समय बता। और यहां कहा जाता है कि श्रुतेश्च विद्वत् फिदरूपकृतायां कथासुदायां उपसंप्रयोगम्। अगर कान का सही तरह से उत्तम उपयोग अगर कोई है, या भगवान ने हमें जो कान दिए उसका अगर सही रूप से प्रयोजन कुछ है, तो वो है कि भगवान की कथा का श्रवण करना। अन्यथा ये कान बताए गए हैं कि ये केवल सर्प के बिल के समान है, इसे हमें समझना चाहिए। जैसे पहले भी हमने चर्चा की है इसी अध्याय में कि सबसे प्रथम जो ज्ञानेंद्रिय है, जिसके द्वारा हम इस भौतिक जगत में ज्ञान प्राप्त करते हैं, वो है कान। कर्णेन्द्रिय ही है कि जिसके द्वारा इस भौतिक जगत में हम ज्ञान प्राप्त करना शुरू करते थे, और उस ज्ञानेन्द्रिय का अगर परिपूर्णता रूप से उत्तम प्रयोजन हमें करना है, तो वो भगवत कथा सुनने के लिए करना है। अन्य किसी चीज में मनुष्य जीवन की सिद्धता जो है वो प्राप्त नहीं हो सकती। और विशेष करके हम देखते हैं कि कई सारे अलग अलग पंथ है या संप्रदाय है जो जीवों को आध्यात्मिकता की ओर लेके जा रहे हैं, और उसका एक ही माध्यम है, वो है कथा। अगर कोई ज्ञान किसी के लिए अगर हमें देना है, तो वह व्यक्ति अपने कानों के द्वारा ही स्वीकारता है। तो ज्ञान का माध्यम जो है वो है कथा। तो कथा किसकी सुननी है? श्रीमद् भागवतम के प्रथम स्कंद से लेकर 12वें स्कंद तक हर अध्याय में हमें इसी के ऊपर बताया गया है कि हमें अगर सुनना ही है तो भगवान के दिव्य लीला गुणों को ही सुनना है। क्योंकि जैसा सुनते हैं वैसा चिंतन होता है, जैसा चिंतन होता है वैसे आचरण होता है, और जैसा आचरण होता है वैसे हमें गति प्राप्त होती है। अगर हम भगवत चिंतन करना चाहते हैं, तो भगवत चिंतन करने के लिए भगवत कथा का श्रवण आवश्यक है। और शास्त्रों में यहां पर बताते हैं कि विद्वत रूप आकृतायाम उपाकृतायाम, के विद्वान ऋषियों ने, जैसे वैदिक सनातन धर्म में हम देखते हैं कि वैदिक सनातन धर्म की शिक्षा है कि हमारे पूर्वज जो थे वे दिव्य ऋषि मुनि थे, जिन्होंने अपने आध्यात्मिक जीवन में प्रगति करने के कारण वे इस भौतिक जगत में रहते हुए भी आध्यात्मिक जगत को देख सकते थे। और जो भौतिक संपन्नता उनके पास थी, जैसे हालांकि हम देखते हैं कि आजकल लोग दिखावे में ज्यादा भरोसा करते हैं कि आदमी कितना दिखाता है उससे उसको वो बहुत ऐश्वर्य संपन्न समझते हैं। आजकल आप देख सकते हैं कि आदमी चाहे बिलेनियर हो मिलेनियर हो, लेकिन एक गाय पाल नहीं सकता अपने घर में, उसको उसके स्टेटस या उसका जो रहन सहन है उसमें उसको कमी लगती है। कितना भी धन हो उसके पास लेकिन गोधन नहीं है किसी के पास। और सनातन धर्म के अनुसार धन्येन धनवान गवो न धनवान गवये धनवान, जिस व्यक्ति के पास प्रचुर मात्रा में धन धान्य हो, अन्न का भंडार जिसका पूरा भरा हुआ हो, और जिसके पास गोधन हो उसको धनवान कहा जाता है। क्योंकि वही चीज है जो आपातकाल में हमारे काम आ सकती है इस भौतिक जगत में। आपके पास चाहे बिलियन डॉलर्स हो लेकिन खाने के लिए घर में अगर अनाज ना हो तो जी नहीं सकते आप। तो असली धनवान व्यक्ति वो है कि जिसके घर में ग्रोसरीज भर के रखी हुई है, बाहर दुकान से उसको ऑर्डर नहीं करना पड़ता हो कि ये मुझे अभी खाना है तो मैं ऑर्डर प्लेस करूंगा और 10-15 मिनट में आ जाएगा फिर खाऊंगा। ऐसे व्यक्ति तो भिखारियों से भी बदतर है। तो सबसे महत्वपूर्ण बात यह है कि व्यक्ति की संपन्नता उसके बाह्य रूप से नहीं बल्कि आंतरिक ज्ञान से मानी जाती है। और ऋषि मुनियों ने अपने साक्षात्कार से जो चिंतन किया है उस चिंतन के द्वारा उन्होंने अनेक ग्रंथों में भगवान के दिव्य लीलाओं का बहुत ही सुंदर रूप से वर्णन किया है। और उस वर्णन को सुनने के पश्चात हम हमारे अस्तित्व को शुद्ध कर सकते हैं। और इसलिए यहां पे कहा गया है कि आत्म साक्षात्कार को प्राप्त करना है तो इन कानों के द्वारा हमें भगवान के दिव्य लीला गुण और कर्मों को समझना है। अन्यथा बहुत ही कठिन। Welcome. Thank you very much. Should I speak in English now?
You could summarize. I apologize. I came to a class and I was here. I was told there were other things going on. And I'm tired.
So today's verse, the highest perfection of human society has explained. It is clearly mentioned that what is that which will give you the highest perfection of human society? Maitreya Rishi says, Ekanta labham vachaso napamsa sushloka mauler gunavadam avu श्रुतेश्च विद्वद्भिर् उपकृतायां कथासुधायां उपसंप्रयोगम्। द हाइएस्ट परफेक्शनल गेन ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटी इज टू एंगेज इन डिस्कशन ऑफ द एक्टिविटीज एंड ग्लोरीज ऑफ द पायस एक्टर। Such activities are so nicely arranged in writing by the greatly learned sages that the actual purpose of the year is served just by being near to them. So here it is recommended that the highest gain or perfectional gain of a humanity is to hear about the Supreme Personality of Godhead. भवद्भिर लोकमंगलम, दैट इज द थिंग विच बिकम्स लोकमंगलम, दैट विल क्रिएट ऑस्पिशियसनेस इन द ह्यूमन सोसाइटी. एंड हाउ वन कैन रेसिप्रोकेट विद दैट? We have a five knowledge acquiring senses, and one of them is ear. And Lord has given us one mouth and two ears, so that we should speak minimum and hear a lot. But what we should hear, that's most important thing. If you dump garbage through this in your heart, what you will accumulate? Garbage only inside. But if you use this for kathasudhayam, kathasudhayam means the nectarian glorification of their lordship. If that goes through these ears, what you will accumulate in your heart? Same thing. And it is said, where you have to go to hear that? Vidvadbhir upakritaya. Vidvadbhir means the most intelligent people. And who are they? The great sages who has wonderfully composed, compiled the wonderful narrations of Lord's pastimes. That means the highest gain of perfection of humanity can be achieved only by associating with the sadhus. And sadhus, association of sadhu means what? Satam prasangar mama virya samvidho. In the association of devotee, what one should do? They should discuss about the glorious pastimes of the Lord. In further chapters, in chapter 25 of same canto, there Kapila Muni, he explains to his mother Devahuti. He tells her that Satam prasangat mamavirya samvidau bhavanti ritkarana prasayanam katha. तज्जोषणादश्वपवर्गवत्मणि श्रद्धा रतिर भक्तिर अनुक्रमिष्यति. He says that सताम प्रसंगात मम वीर्य संविदो. One should give oral deception in the association of सताम. सताम means who are attached to, सताम means Lord. In the association of devotee, if you give oral deception to the narrations of Lord's wonderful pastimes, then what happens? Bhavanti ritkarana rasayana kataha. That narrations becomes karana rasayana. Karana rasayana means the elixir that goes through your ear and accumulates it at heart. Rut karana rasai. And further it is explained. Because of that, what happens? Tad shoshanad ashvapavarga vartmani. When one gives this oral reception to the wonderful nectarian pastimes of their lordship, then his heart become enlightened. Choshna means it get enlightened. Ashuhu, and immediately that person starts walking on the path of apavargaha. He starts walking on the path of Vaikuntha. So where it leads to you? In our childhood, when we used to do some notorious activities, to bring us to senses, our parents, they used to pull our ears. I was wondering that why they used to pull ear. But now that I am understanding that, to correct yourself, you need to hear properly. So they used to indicate us that by doing so, that use this to acquire knowledge and become intelligent in this world, rather than using other senses. This is what gives you a proper knowledge, how to do and what to do. This is what navigates you. And only the person who is on the post of guru or spiritual master can hold your ears. Not everyone. If someone younger does it for the elder one, it is considered as an insult. Because that authority is only for the person who is authority in your life and who has that qualification to guide you. So this is what navigates you actually. If you hear dumb prajalpa or garbage, you are going to accumulate that same thing in your heart. And few years back, one of the Japanese scientists, he made a research on water. 71% of our body is water only. So if you hear positive things, that will have a positive impact on you. He showed it by experiment. Under the microscope, he saw the molecular structure of water. If someone keeps a water and speaks some bad words, then the whole molecular structure becomes obnoxious. It looks like a fungus. But if you keep that water and play a wonderful music, which is soothing to your heart, it forms wonderful molecular structure in the water. If you chant some Vedic hymns, that prepares more wonderful structure that most attractive. That means as much as positive you hear, you become more and more energized. The body, which is containing 71% of water, will reciprocate you in that way. See, in the previous eras, whatever our ancestor, especially the people who follow the Sanatan Dharma, they have done it with a scientific reason. Problem is that nowadays people, they are researching it and bringing it forth with the scientific evidences. But previously it was established with that. In our childhood, if someone used to get a bad eye or evil eye, then that person used to suffer because of some bodily alignments. Is not to able to eat, not able to sleep. Then they used to chant some particular mantras. And they used to move around as some fire or some water. Or they used to chant some particular mantras and they used to give that water to drink. And that used to give soothing effect in that particular dilemma. And small kids, they used to get out of that particular bodily alignment. I was wondering how it is working. But as I started studying this, now realize that mantras, it is not just they meant for delivering your mind, but to deliver you from this material world. Because each and everything in this world is controlled by the sound. Do you know that? Everything in this world is controlled by the sound. Because sound is the first element, gross element amongst the Panchamahabhuta was created. And that's why it is known as the Shabda Brahma, the source of everything. And whenever you speak anything, that stays eternally in the ether and has its effect on everyone. Why there is a chaos in the world? Because all the people, they speak so much about negativity. Anywhere you go, you will find people, either they are rebuking someone, they are ridiculing someone, they are speaking some negative about someone. So automatically that gives that negative impact on you. because water is so sensitive for negativity and the vibrations. Why we offer food to their lordship and chant different mantras? When you chant mantras, these mantras create such a wonderful atmosphere in the environment that soothes your mind. As I met so many people who regularly visit the temple, everyone they say that when we come to your temple, our mind is so peaceful, it's soothing. Why is it so? Can you explain that? Why is it so? Because our head pujari, he keeps playing Prabhupada's kirtan all day long. So that pure sound vibration of a pure devotee creates the environment so purified. When you come here, your mind becomes very calm. Because the 71% of water in your body that forms such a wonderful molecular structure in your body, automatically all alignments in the body which are creating trouble for you, that gets neutralized. And you feel fresh. Your consciousness, your grass body, everything becomes fresh. Even Ayurveda also says that what is the source of our sickness or disease? Purva janma kritam papam vyadhi rupena badate. The papa, the sinful activities that you have done in your previous life, that comes in the form of a disease in this life, and you suffer for that.
Comes in the form of disease.
What do you say in American language?
Disease.
So I'm having a proper pronunciation.
Disease.
Okay. Disease. So that word, the source of our disease is our papa, sinful activity. And how to get rid of that? The first and foremost, it is said, Govinda Nama Anukirtane. If you want to get rid of your sins or any disease that you have, you should chant the holy name of Lord Govinda. You should glorify his activities. And then he says, Aushadha and other things. The first and foremost thing is chant the holy name of Lord. We have one sannyasi. His only name is Shukadev Goswami Maharaj. He himself is MD in Morrison's from London. We never saw him taking any sort of a medicines. Whenever he used to get sick, he will give up food and he will sit and just chant and drink water. That's his medicine. And we have seen he gets cured from that. The person being MD himself in medicine is not taking any medicines to get rid of his disease. Because he has a full faith that this holy name only can cure you from your disease. And we have evidence for that also. Scriptures also says that, and here is the pramana or evidence that this person is following. If someone is frequently getting disease, then they should understand that something is wrong with sadhana. One foolish fellow, he asked, we have seen Prabhupada also was getting sick. That means he does not have a good sadhana or what? But the rascal has to understand that Prabhupada has taken a responsibility of all of us to take us back to Godhead. And the person who takes the responsibility, he gets 1/6 of your sinful activities. Can you imagine? It's not that easy to become a leader. people foolishly they think that oh I should become a leader and get a post and position and I can manage the people. But this foolish fellow there does not understand that when you get that lead, you are getting the 1/6% of karma, especially the sinful activities, the people who are working under you, you are responsible for that. And that's why in the Vedic terminology, king was also considered as a papi. Not a punyatma, considered as a papatma. Why? Because he is responsible for the 1/6 of sins that has done by the citizens. Can you imagine? Then how strong that person should be spiritually to lead the society. And today we see that there is, you don't have such a leadership. And that's why there is a chaos in the world. Most of the leaders, they are dying because of worse diseases. Because followers, they are not following what they're supposed to follow, what they have committed to that leader. So he's responsible for that and he has to suffer. I was wondering that most of the Prabhupada senior disciples, they are dying because of some obnoxious disease. Most of them dies because of cancer. What's the reason behind that? This is what, as per the scripture. They are good in their sadhana, but not enough to do the sadhana. As much as responsibility you take, as much as followers you make, it is your responsibility to take care of their personal life. That's why we choose the spiritual master. Rupa Goswami Pad clearly says, don't read too much and don't accept disciples too much. Read that much which you can understand and accept that much which you can digest. Otherwise, your spiritual life is on task. Once His Holiness Bhaktichara Swami Maharaj was explaining one of the senior devotees. He came to visit him in the hospital and I was happened to be there. I was taking care of that senior devotee. So Bhaktichara Maharaj came and he said, see, we are not following our previous acharyas. As Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Maharaj quoted it from Bhaktivinoda Thakur's writings, that Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to say, first, health. Second, sadhana. And third is prachar, preaching. But nowadays, we go topsy-turvy. Give first preference to preaching, then sadhana, and then think about health. And that is creating a chaos everywhere. And it is logical to understand. If your health is not good, this body, which is considered as a idam shariram khalu dharma sadhanam, this body is instrumental in performing your religious duties. If you don't have a proper body, which is not comfortable to perform any sort of a service, what do you think? Are you able to engage yourself in the Lord's service? If you have a problem to hear and you are not taking care of that, are you going to hear about the Lord? No. So you should have your earphones, your machine through which you can hear it properly. If you don't have a proper eyesight, you can't dress deities, can you? No. If this instrument is not properly, you will not get a proper performance. So this sadhanam, idam shariram khalu dharma sadhanam, this instrument should be taken care properly. That does not mean you just concentrate on taking care of this instrument, but you should use it for its real purpose. And that is sadhana. This body is meant for purifying ourselves, not to degrade ourselves by enjoying our own bodily senses. that we have to understand. Idam shariram khalu dharma sadhana. When this is taken care, then sadhana will be proper. Like most of the time we see most of the devotees, when they sit, especially for the chanting, they doze. They fall asleep. Why is it so? Stomach is not clear. If stomach is not clear, it creates gases that goes to the head and you feel like a nausea. It's a simple logic. But we are not that much into understanding our own body. So we don't know that. And we give so many reasons for that. Oh, I know, never slept night. So I'm having problem this. But real problem is there with your body. Why this pranayama and yogic process has given? Due to the pranayama, the whole oxygen can goes through all the tissues of your body and it keeps you refreshed. When we breathe, we are not breathing fully. We are not using our lungs 100%. Most of the time, common person, they use 20% of their lungs for breathing. And that's why they are having a short life span. Because our lifespan is considered on the counts of our inhaling and exhaling, not on the years. That's why in the scripture, brahmacharya is recommended. Because in the sexual activities, you lose a lot of inhaling and exhaling. So person who does that, he loses his lifespan. So through pranayama, prana ayam. Ayam means stopping. Inhale and wait for a while. Exhale and wait for a while. So that increases span of your inhaling and exhaling. So automatically your lifespan is increased. And as much as actual oxygen that you take in your body, your tissues get regenerated. And generally you see the person who, while sitting, when he sits bend, then he loses that inhaling and exhaling. So minimum oxygen content goes to body and you feel asleep. You fall asleep. So best way, that's why in one of the Prabhupada's japa recording, you can see, he says, sit straight. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Sit straight. You will hear that. Prabhupada clearly says that, sit straight. When you sit straight, you become more attentive. If you don't do that, you are losing. And you don't have a proper sadhana, what are you going to preach others? If I have $100, I can give you 90. But I myself have $10 and I'm planning to give you $40. How is it possible? Then I'm cheating myself or I'm cheating the person? Both. First of all, I'm cheating myself because what I don't have, I'm trying to give it. And cheating the other person, that showing him that I know I'm having 100%. That is nonsense. And that preaching will be not effective. Once we asked one of the senior sannyasis, why when Prabhupada was there, so many centers they opened up. There is like every 15 days, new city, new center. And nowadays, like this temple, for 20 years it is here. Where are the devotees? Why? Because nobody is there to give what's supposed to be given. If people feel that while going there, we are getting something which is nourishing our soul, they will keep coming. If you don't give that, then what will happen? Nobody will come there. It will be just like a social gathering. Like Sundays we have to go somewhere, so let's go to temple. But that will not create great impact on their consciousness. If they feel that when we go there, it gives nourishment to our soul. And when that will happen, when the residents of temple will have proper sadhana. people they think that if more people will come then more money will come and we will maintain the temple. It never happens like that. If you have a proper sadhana, Lord will get pleased with you and he will provide whatever your necessity is there. This fundamental thing we are missing. Now, how do you think that we can make some progress, tangible progress in our spiritual life? Because the most essential thing that has explained here, the highest gain of humanity, which is hearing about the Lord, if you don't have a taste for that and you are not able to create that taste in others, then what's the use of all these things? We arrange for the programs, but we give less botheration or least preference to the katha. Maybe you speak for 10 minutes or 20 minutes. The rest of the thing, they spend time on that. Unless and until you don't understand what you are doing, do you think that will give you the proper effect? Yes or no? No. For that reason, in Russia, preaching is expanding so much. Yesterday I had a talk with one of our DT ministry devotee. And he was surprised. He went there for new temple coming up there. And people from 100 miles, 200 miles away from that particular place. But they had such a strong desire to know about how to render deity worship. From all the places they were coming together. And he said, I was surprised that I had a 4 hours continuous session with them. They were asking so many questions. After that, he said, another seminar I had. That went for the 5 hours. Because these Russian people, they are so much into Harikatha, hearing. My spiritual master first, when he went to US, when he came back, he told us that the devotees, they have such a strong inclination toward hearing that they can sit without eating food, drinking water for 7 hours to hear about Lord. And he did give classes for 7 hours, 6 hours on Gaurlila. And that's what creating a wild fire there, and it's boosting like anything about Krishna consciousness. Thousands and thousands of people are coming together. You will see on the Facebook, you will find most of the Russian devotees, they are on the road every day for another Sankirtan. They are there for the classes. Hundreds of people, they come for classes. Here you will find people to eat, hundreds of them, they will come. But for classes, one by one, because they are not understood the real essence. You may have as our leader say, that here there is a, what door they called? Circular door. No, the door which keeps moving up. Round door they call. That one comes and other goes, one comes, other goes. Nobody stays. Because the environment is not conducive or suitable for that. And as for last 20, 25 years, as I was traveling everywhere, I have seen the temples, most of the temples, where there is a proper katha is going on. Where there is a proper discussions about Lord's pastime is going on. That temples are flourishing. They don't have to take bag and beggar, go out and beg money for that. Lord is providing everything there in that temple itself. Because we don't have that faith. It is clearly said here, the highest perfectional gain of humanity is to hear about the glories of the Lord. And if you miss that one, then where you are going to get what? Mandanam lokaranjanam, like a decorating the dead body. Is that going to help that body? No. That's why in the last part of this purport, Prabhupada says, Srimad Bhagavatam is one of such a great literatures, and the highest perfectional state of a life is attained simply by hearing and reciting its contents. So what is going to give you the highest perfectional gain? It's hearing about their lordship. That's the parameter for us. How much intense desire that you have to hear about. Once I asked my spiritual master, Gurudev, how I can understand that whatever I am rendering a devotional service, that Lord is accepting it. Otherwise, whatever I am doing, that is useless. If I don't know whether Lord is accepting it or not. Then he told me a simple sentence which has changed my perception of about rendering activities. He said, after doing that service, if your attachment for chanting the holy name and attachment for hearing about the Lord increases, that means Lord is accepting services from you. Does it make some sense? If you are thinking enough of now katha, enough of now chanting, that means there is something wrong in your service that you are rendering. There is something problem with your own sadhana. That's the parameter. Simple way to understand whether you are making progress in spiritual life or not. Whether you are developing taste in holy name or not. Whether Lord is accepting your service or not. Whether Lord is pleased with you or not. Because see, the real essence as explained in this verse. Maitreya Rishi clearly says, the highest perfectional gain of the humanity is to engage in discussion of the activities and glories of the Lord. Pious creator, it is explained here. Why this pious creator? Why that world is there particularly? Because to purify your existence, you need to be the most purified thing. To have a strong effect, you need to have a concentrated solution. Same way, if you really want to get purified, you need to have the most purified thing with you. That only can purify you. And who is that? Sushlokam ahu maulihi. The person who is glorified with the wonderful shlokas, uttama shlokas, and whose activities are so pure, by hearing about them, your heart gets nourished. Your heart gets purified. And there is only one thing, and that is the glories of the Lord that we have to hear. Shunvatam svakata Krishna punya shravana kirtanaha. What happens if you hear about the Lord? Punya. That increases your pious activities. That purifies your heart. Bhidyate hridaye granthi chidyante sarva samshaya kshyante chasya karmani drishteva atmanishvare. All the knots of attachment in the heart, bhidyate, they get cut. When you fly a kite, when you draw it back, so whole thread comes all together, and sometimes it gets entangled in each other. Then it becomes very difficult to get it cleared. So what do you do that time? Rather than wasting time, you just cut that thing. So same way, there are so many aspirations are there in the heart for the material enjoyment. They will not go like that. So what do you have to do? Bhidyate hridaye granthi, you have to cut them out. Chidyante sarva samshaya, you have to cut out all your doubts How? By hearing about the Lord. Kshyanti chasya karmani. And that will, kshyante means it will decay all your reactions over activities. And then you will be able to see the Lord who resides in your heart. Drashtayeva atmanishvare. So that's the way through which we can understand the Lordship. Okay? So any comment, any question?
When I was in Chicago, a few of the devotees, the upper devotees, wanted to come together for reading and discussing the Charitamrita. So I thought, oh, they're so elevated. And, but then I thought, I don't know if I could like go and see and hear it.
You can start it. If you start, people will come. If nobody starts, who will come? Simple thing. If they know that someone is there to give us, they will come.
It wasn't like anyone was a great scholar.
No need of scholarship. Open up any Prabhupada books and just repeat as it is. You will become scholar. Be the transparent via media. Just say what he has written. People will listen to you. As long as the part of any machine is connected with that machine, it has a value. If it is apart from that machine, it is scrap, trash. So as long as you are speaking what is there in the written, in the book, people will get attracted to you. They will try to listen to you because you have Pramana as a Shastra. Not your speculation. And only sincere soul will get attracted to that. The garbage seller or garbage collector will not come to you. They will keep distance from you. But who really is sick for the nectar, that swan or span, what do you say?
Swan.
Swan will come to you, not swine. So if you have that desire, and I have seen for last 2 decades, the person who read well Prabhupada books, automatically his heart craves, he has that craving in his heart to speak it out to someone, to tell it to someone. Hey, you know, I read this, this is what Prabhupada says. You must be having that craving. If you read something, you feel like I should share it with someone.
People are not knowing the truth, so tell them the truth.
Yeah. So that compassion for the living entity, that comes in. Because you are connected with yourself with the most compassionate person. Who has it, he can give you. I started like that. I was staying in one of the temples. And there they used to have only a Sunday program. Once in a week people used to come together. I thought that why we should not have every day evening. Okay, then president said it's not possible. I said at least one day when they have that weekly off of that particular place, why we should not? So then say, oh, we don't have a money, you know. If they come, then we have to feed them prasad and we can't do that. I said, who are you to feed them? They are coming to you to just hear something. If they hear it, they themselves will think that they wanted to do something, they will do it. And that's what happened. The first day we had a program, and one person came, he saw, he sat there, he said, actually, I'm coming for years together, but I never heard like this. So anything that I can do for you? I said, okay. Today we don't have any prasad. He said, okay. He just phoned someone. And one person came along with one bag of rice, one bag of dal, and one tin of oil. He said, you can just make khichdi and serve it. And from next time, Lord arranged himself that whoever wants to come, then the next time another person came, and he had his factory for suji. So he said, from my side, I'm giving one full bag. There, one bag means 100 kg, 200 pounds. Per month, he said, I'm ready to give. Someone came, he said, this is what sugar I can give you. So, if you give people, they will give. What do you have to give? The highest gain of humanity. And what is that? Harikatha. And if you don't do that, you will run mall only. Some social gatherings. Got it? When they get that sense of getting something, they will also have a desire to give something. Unless and until you don't develop that thing with them, nothing will work out. You start. Who is restricting you to start reading that? When I was in Brahmacharya Ashram for 7 years, every day evening before going to bed, it was our schedule. We used to sit all together, drink milk and read from Krishna book and go to sleep. When, why Maya will attack in you? She will not disturb your mind. As that famous English proverb is there, who prays together, they stress together. If you don't pray together, how you can expect that you will stay together? Is that possible? And Prabhupada has given such a wonderful system that whole day, 365 days of years, what you are doing? From morning to evening, you are just praying to their Lordship. So just come together. We have a 5 people, and how many are there for the prayers? Huh? Do we really realize about that? No. We do it just to show someone, okay, president is coming, so I am there. You're doing it for president or you're doing it for yourself? So you need to be sincere and serious in your endeavor. Because that's what gets counted ultimately. Otherwise, punarabhi jananam, punarabhi maranam, punarabhi janani, jathare shayanam. For millions of lifetimes, you have to just wander again, aimlessly. Make use of this. Finish it all. Not looking back now. Whatever happens, so happen. Make some sense? Thank you.
हम लोग साधन में सबसे साधन था होता है
सेवा उतनी करो कि जिसमें आप अपनी साधना ठीक तरह से कर सको. ये तो सेवा करते जा रहा है जपा दो दो दिन तीन तीन दिन का जपा नहीं किया, फायदा क्या फिर उसका? सेवा तभी अच्छी तरह से होगी जब साधना ठीक तरह से होगी. 2 घंटा बैठ के अगर 16 माला जप नहीं कर पाए तो सेवा 24 घंटा करोगे तो भी फायदा नहीं आपको, क्योंकि सारा सब कुछ करना है भगवान का स्मरण करने के लिए, तो वही नहीं हो पा रहा है. एक मशीन के जैसे लगे पड़े तो क्या फायदा है उसका? किन की
उनको सेवा कर रहे हैं, उनको धुन में है.
कौन सी धुन में है?
भगवान का
नहीं होता प्रभु,
तो फिर
नहीं होता है. हम वो स्तर पे है नहीं है अभी तक कि हर समय केवल भगवान के बारे में सोच के ही कर रहे हैं. अरे 2 घंटा बैठ के जप नहीं कर पा रहे हो तो 24 घंटा भगवान की सेवा क्या करोगे आप?
तो गंदे बैठने के लिए तो बैठ के जप करना तो सबसे बहुत बढ़िया.
करोगे कब? कर? अगले जन्म में
करते
वैसे नहीं होता प्रभु. प्रभुपाद ने बोला है सबसे पहला प्राधान्य है हमारी जपा के लिए, अगर वो नहीं हुआ तो फिर आगे का क्या होगा हमसे।
बैठ के खाना करता था,
पढ़ता था नहीं, करना ही है, करना ही है, पढ़ता था यानी ये ऑब्लिगेशन हो गया कि अरे भाई करना है अभी मंदिर में रह कर करके, नहीं ये मेरे लिए कर रहा हूं, ये मेरे लिए है। मिनिमम 16 माला प्रभुपाद ने तभी तो बोला है कि अगर इतना करोगे तो बाकी मैं कर लूंगा करके, 30% ये संभालो तो 70% मैं संभालूंगा, उसमें भी हम अगर ड्रामा करेंगे तो मतलब क्या है।
अभी तो सेवक साथ सुबह 1 घंटा आधा घंटा, फिर उस सेवा फिर दोपहर टाइम दोपहर को आधा घंटा
सेवा को सुनियोजित करो ना, सुनियोजित करो उसको। अभी मैंने देखा आपको सुबह रात भर भी आप उस पूरा श्रृंगार का सामान जमा करके रखते हैं, फिर सुबह भी आधा घंटा उसी में डाल देते हैं, एक ही समय पे करो ना तो सेवा यहाँ की जल्दी हो जाएगी। थोड़ा उसका नियोजन अच्छी तरह से करो, आपके फायदे के लिए है, नहीं तो फिर मैंने तो नहीं देखा, अभी 1 साल यहाँ पे रुका हूँ, मैं रह रहा हूँ आप लोगों के साथ, मैंने कभी नहीं देखा आपको बैठ के जपा करते हुए, हाथ में माला लेके घूमोगे, गायत्री करते समय भी चलते रहोगे, ये पद्धति नहीं है, ये साधना है, उसके नियम है थोड़े, उसको पालन करना पड़ेगा ना, घूमते फिरते करने के लिए साधन नहीं है, उससे गंभीरता नहीं आती है।
सही बात
कब करोगे फिर, सही बात है, तो सही बात तभी लगती है जब हम उसको अपने आचरण में लाते हैं, तो फिर कहने के लिए सही हो जाती है, आवश्यक है प्रभु, नहीं तो फिर ऐसे फिर साल निकल गए, कितने हो गए, 30 साल हो गए जब कर रहे हैं, अरे कुछ लग रहा है,
लगता है
बैठ के करना चाहिए, नीड टू बी डेडिकेट स्पेसिफिक टाइम फॉर स्पेसिफिक थिंग्स, देन इट विल मेक चेंज, डेफिनेटली इट क्रिएट चेंज। मैंने देखा आपको कई बार आप खड़े हो के गायत्री करते रहते हो, फिर उसी में ही आके लॉक खोलते हो, गायत्री ये उसकी पद्धति है ना। अभी मैं आपको समझाना ठीक नहीं है क्योंकि मुझसे 10-15 साल पहले आप कर रहे हो, बैठ के करो उसको शांति से करो, क्योंकि वही मंत्र है जो आपको तारेगा। अगर उसी में भी हम अगर अरे ये लॉक नहीं खुल रहा है, फिर इधर उधर देखेंगे, फिर मन विचलित हो जाता है ना उसके कारण। वो 5 मिनट में आप बैठ के करके आके कर सकते हैं, इतना ही, ऐसा नहीं कि कोई फ्लाइट मिस हो रहा है या कुछ मिस हो रहा है अगर वो लॉक नहीं खोलेंगे तो, थोड़ा सा नियोजन आवश्यक है, बाकी तो चल रहा है भगवान की कृपा से, लेकिन इसमें फिर और प्रेम आ जाएगा, जल्दी से जल्दी और प्रगति कर पाएंगे, नहीं तो फिर ठीक है सालों साल लगे ही रहेंगे, एक गया और एक जन्म मिल जाएगा और एक जन्म मिल जाएगा,
जब करते भी इधर उधर बोलना भी नहीं। फिर
देखो मेरा मोस्टली दिन में जब यहाँ पे होता नहीं कि कोई ना कोई आ जाता है या फोन बज जाता है, तो वो माला मुझे फिर से करनी पड़ती है, तो दिन भर वो 16 माला को खींचना पड़ता है। अगर एक बार सुबह ही बैठ के हो गया तो फिर दिन भर चिंता नहीं रहती, क्योंकि जिसके लिए जो स्पेसिफिक समय है उसमें करोगे तो अच्छा है, वो मदद करता है। नहीं तो कई लोग सोचते कि जब भी आओ देखो इसका बिड़बैग में हाथ रहता है, इसीलिए रहता है कि वो 16 माला का फिर जो 2 घंटे में होना है वो 8 घंटा हो जाता है उसके लिए।
और मंगलवार से पहले मैं 8 माला कर देता,
जो जिसको उचित लगे उसी प्रकार से साधना करे और करे, वो सबसे महत्वपूर्ण है।
हरे
ठीक है, हरे कृष्ण,
तो एकदम आशीर्वाद तो बैठ के जब नहीं।